This scene shows the events that activate muscle contraction and the biochemical details of cross-linking and sliding of the actin filaments by the myosin heads. The cycle starts when an electrical impulse from a motor neuron stimulates a muscle fiber. Invertebrate animals may have one, two, or three motor neurons that control the contraction of a single muscle fiber, and each motor neuron has multiple end plate junctions spread over the fiber surface. The nerve signal from a motor neuron does not generate an action potential in an invertebrate muscle fiber, but rather depolarizes the entire surface of the fiber to produce contraction. The electrical depolarization also spreads into tiny membranous invaginations of the fiber membrane called transverse tubules, or T-tubules. The T-tubules extend to the myofibrils. The T-tubules align with the A-band in invertebrate muscles. The T-tubules essentially carry the electrical signal into the sarcoplasm and along the sarcoplasmic reticulum, a complex of membranous vesicles that serve to store calcium within the muscle. Depolarization of the T-tubule membrane activates calcium release channels of the sarcoplasmic reticulum to release stored calcium into the sarcoplasm. The released calcium then initiates the muscle contraction by binding to a protein called troponin. Calcium-activated troponin causes a conformational shift in the protein tropomyosin, which winds around the actin helix and blocks the myosin binding sites on the actin molecules. This frees the actin molecules to bind the myosin head units. The contraction cycle starts with the myosin head bound to adenosine triphosphate, ATP. The myosin head contains adenosine triphosphatase, an enzyme that splits the high-energy phosphate bond of ATP to produce adenosine diphosphate, ADP, an inorganic phosphate. The resulting ADP and inorganic phosphate remain associated with the myosin head, which is also charged with the energy released by the splitting of the high-energy phosphate from the ATP. To start the contraction cycle, the myosin head attaches loosely to actin, then releases the inorganic phosphate, which causes tight binding with the actin. After tight binding, proteins in the myosin head undergo a conformational change that results in repositioning the angle of attachment between the myosin head and the actin. The shift to the new conformation pulls the actin along the myosin. After pulling the actin, myosin exchanges ADP for a new molecule of ATP. This results in release of the myosin head from the actin. The myosin head resumes its relaxed conformation and position, and the cycle is ready to repeat. Let us watch the cycle repeat several times.